Unit 2, Hardware, Session 4. At the end of the session, you will learn about some more related devices or computer peripherals. Scanner. The scanner is used for scanning the images or documents optically and to convert them to digital image. What do you mean by optically? Optically means those related with light. Haven't you seen a scanner while scanning the images, a red light is passing over these images or documents? Yes. So that is why we are calling the scanner as an optical scanner, because they are using light for scanning the images or documents. And one more duty is there for the scanner. It converts them to digital image. The computer only understands the digital language. So the scanner converts the scanned images or documents to digital image, then only the computer can read this data. Alright? So we have already studied the devices which give input or data to the computers are called input devices. So the scanner is giving scanned images or documents as an input to the computer. So scanner is an input device. Now let's move on to the next peripheral device or related device, microphone. Very familiar for you, right? It is a device that receives or takes sound from a particular direction. So they are taking sound from the user and giving to the computer. So microphone is also giving input or data to the computer. So we can call microphone also as an input device. Now let's move on to the next peripheral device or related devices. Speakers. It is a device used to produce sound of music, song, video, etc. Here, the speakers are producing the results or output as a sound of music, song or video. So we can call speaker as an output device. All right. Now let's move on to the next peripheral device. Web camera. Web camera is used to give video input to the computer. We all know that web camera captures the images or videos and give as an input to the computer. So web camera is also an input device. Moreover, it works like an eye of the computer. Computer uses web camera to see the surroundings, right? Yes. Now let's move on. Barcode reader. I think everybody has seen this barcode reader, right? I'm damn sure everybody has visited supermarkets for purchasing something, right? Haven't you seen this barcode reader in the billing area? Now, what is the use of barcode reader? Yes, it is an optical scanner used to read the printed barcodes. Again, here the word optical has come. From the word itself, it's very clear it is related with light. So here also, the barcode reader is using the light to read the barcodes. Now, what is a barcode? Yes, this is the barcodes. We are using barcode reader to read this barcode by using light. And that is why we are calling it as an optical scanner. All right. And one more duty is there for barcode reader. Can anybody read these barcodes? No, nobody can read these barcodes, right? So it is the duty of a barcode reader to decode this data and send them to the computer, right? The barcode reader decodes these barcodes and then it sends them to the computer. Then only we can read the details of the purchased product. So, what is the use of a barcode reader? It reads, or it is an optical scanner, it reads the printed barcodes, then it decodes these data and send them to the computer. So, here also the barcode reader is giving an input or data to the computer. So, barcode reader is an input device. That is also known as barcode scan. Alright, so these are all about peripheral devices or computer peripherals or related devices. All these devices are connected externally to the computer. Alright, okay. Yes, that's all for today's class, and this is the end of this chapter, hardware. Now in our next class, let's begin with a new chapter. Thank you.